Congratulations, you made awesome content. It looks great, your clients love it, it's on brand, and it's live. Now what? I know you love your content, but unfortunately, that's not really a good indicator if it was worth your time. Content that is actually worth your time is content that your audience loves, because we live in a society and you're trying to make money. So, how do you know what content to invest in? What landing pages are making you the most money, and what form design is holding your campaign back? Today, I'm going to take you through Involve.me's built-in analytics and show you which metrics you need to be paying attention to. There are three ways to look at your analytics: organization level, project level, and cross-project level. Organization level analytics shows you the overall performance of everything you made. All your forms, quizzes, landing pages, everything. They are great if you want to have a quick look at your month and see growth and drastic changes compared with the previous month. The guiding metric here is the completion rate. It shows you how many people that viewed your content made it to the final page and answered all your questions. It's a very important number, so if you only have time to look at one thing, that's the one thing you should look at. Project level analytics has the same metrics, but it also has a lot of additional data that goes more in depth, because project level analytics is for one project only. So if you make a lead generation quiz and you want to know all about the specifics about how your quiz is performing, what answers people selected most frequently, this is where you would check. Click on the little drop-down arrow on the specific project you want to view the analytics on, and then select Analytics. If you scroll down the Summary tab, you will find things like Outcome Results Distribution. This will tell you what page people end on the most and least frequently. And you will also find Response Summary. Here's where you can see what answers are most popular. This is perfect for surveys or understanding your audience at a scale. In the Detailed Metrics tab, you can see the conversion funnel. It goes from how many people visited your project, how many people started interacting with your project, how many people create any type of data submission, like answering a question, for example, how many people completed a submission, which means they've made it to the final page of your project, and how many leads you've collected. The funnel is color-coded by device type, and you can get more insight into what devices are used to view your project. You can also see what country your audience is from. If you keep scrolling, you can see which embeds are getting the most engagement if you embedded the project on more than one website. And lastly, you have the question funnel, which are funnels for each question, which can help you figure out where people drop off and how you can fix it. The next tab you have is responses. Here you can look at each individual response that you received on your project. By clicking on each individual response, you can see the information they left behind and what questions they filled out. If you find a response that has a yellow question mark next to it, that means it's a partial submission, and upon clicking on it, you can decide if you want to reveal the answers or you want to just leave it. Partial submissions are a type of submission when a user doesn't complete your entire project. They close the tab before completing it, but they do leave some information behind. Whether you'd like to reveal this information and count it into your submission limit is up to you. If you just want to quickly get your leads, personal data is where you can find this. It has everything you included in the contact details drag and drop content element on your project. Clicking the eye icon will show you the detailed responses of the selected lead. For a quick look at your payment details, you can go to Payments and you can see all complete and incomplete payments. Simply click Paid or Not Paid and choose a submission to show this information for. You can download your reports that contain all data collected. If you download it as a CSV, only key metrics and personal data will be downloaded. If you download it as an XLS, you have the question data on the second sheet. Now let's move on to the types of submissions. A submission is created when data is collected through a live Involve.me project. There are four types of submissions: complete submissions, unrevealed partial submissions, revealed partial submissions, and expired submissions. A complete submission is made every time a user makes it to the final page of your project. With a complete submission, you can be sure that all information that you asked for has been filled out and completed. Only complete submissions count toward your monthly submission limit, unless you manually choose to reveal partial submissions. Partial submissions are created when someone fills out some information, but not all. They abandon the project before making it to the final page. They may or may not have left their contact information behind. Revealed partial submissions, however, do count toward your monthly submission limit. Expired submissions are partial submissions that you have not revealed within 30 days. They disappear completely after 45 days after we have safely deleted them. This is due to GDPR and data protection laws and regulations. Now, let's have a look at partial submissions. There are three types of partial submissions. Firstly, unrevealed partial submissions that are marked by an orange icon. Secondly, revealed partial submissions marked by a yellow icon. And thirdly, expired partial submissions marked by a gray icon. Unrevealed is the default setting for partial submissions. You can choose to reveal them one by one or in bulk for a certain project. Once you reveal a submission, it behaves like a completed submission. You can export it and view its submission details. This is why revealed partial submissions count toward your monthly submission limit. Always keep GDPR and data protection laws and regulations when working with partial submissions. If you're based outside of the EU and are not concerned with GDPR, you can choose to not receive submissions from within the EU. You can do that within project settings by scrolling down to personal data and ticking the box that says block users from within EU. Well, that is it for today's video. I really hope this video helped you understand analytics a little bit better and that now you know how to use it more to your benefit. If you did enjoy this video, please make sure to give it a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell so you're notified every time we post a new video. Thanks for watching. Bye.